Hello everyone, in this video I'm going to explain about rehashing. It is a process of recalculating the hash code of already stored entries and moving them to another bigger size hash table. Now let us see the example for rehashing. Here the values are 7, 16, 33 and 42 and the table size is 7. By using the hash function, 7 is inserted at the key 0. 16 is placed at the key 2, 33 is placed at the key 5, and 42 is placed at the key 6. Now I want to insert 22 into the hash table, so it is placed at the key 1. To rehash the table, first take the table size and double the table size and take the nearest prime value. Here the table size is 7. Double the table size, it means 14, and the nearest prime number is 17. So the rehashing table size is 17. By using the hash function xmod 17, the values 7, 16, 33, 42, and 22 are placed in the hash table. Here 22 is placed at the key value 5, 7 is placed at the key value 7, 42 is placed at the key value 8, 33 is placed at the key value 15 and 16 is placed at the key value 16. So this is about the rehashing. Next is extendable hashing. It is a dynamic hashing method where directories and buckets are used to hash the data. Where directory stores pointers to buckets and buckets stores hashed keys here. Next is working of extendable hashing. First analyze the data elements and convert into binary values. Now check global depth of directory. Here, global depth is nothing but number of bits in the directory. The bits may be 0 or 1 or 0, 0, 1, 1, etc. Next, identify the directory and navigation, which means check the position in the directory. After that, insert the values and check the overflow here. Overflow the condition during the data insertion. If overflow occurs, then go to step 7. You have to tackle the overflow condition during the insertion of data. Otherwise, go to next step. Rehashing of split bucket elements. Here, bucket elements are hashed key values. And finally, the element is successfully hashed. Now, let us see the example for extendable hashing. These are the bits. And bucket stores the hash key values. Here, we are taking two binary bits. So, the global depth of directory is 2. As we know that the binary value of 64 and 44 contains 00 at the end. So these are placed at the 00 binary bits. And the binary value of 9, 25 and 5 contains 01 at the end. So 01 contains 9, 25 and 5 key values. The binary value of 10 has 10 at the end. So it is placed at the 10 bit. And the binary values of 3, 31, 15 and 7 contains 11 at the end. So 11 contains key values 3, 31, 15 and 7. So this is about the extendable hashing. Thank you.